The President, Frank, attempted to pay his respects to Aretha Franklin today. Listen to how he describes the late legend.
Well, I want to begin today by expressing my condolences to the family of a person I knew well. She worked for me on numerous occasions. She was terrific. Aretha Franklin, on her passing. She's brought joy to millions of lives, and her extraordinary legacy will thrive and inspire many generations to come. She was given a great gift from God, her voice, and she used it well. People loved Aretha. She's a special woman, so I just want to pass on my warmest best wishes and sympathies to her family.
How do you think she would have felt by being described as someone who worked for him?
You know, just when you think you've stared into the abyss of Donald Trump's narcissism and seen your way to the bottom, you realize there are a couple thousand feet below that. And saying she worked for him, and that's what the second sentence out of his mouth, that's just offensive.
But you know what? He doesn't get it.
No, I don't.
He doesn't think that that's offensive. I'm sure the people around him probably didn't think it was offensive. I'm sure some of his supporters. But it is offensive.
No, but you and I are awful people to even point it out. But, you know, you're talking about an American legend here who had great meaning to a great many people. And to reduce her to, she worked for me, is incredibly offensive and classic Donald Trump.
He thinks he's doing something nice by expressing his condolences. But there's a way to do things properly and to put an ownership on a person saying, she worked for me. It's just... I want to keep my job, so I won't say.
Well, but, Don, you mind if I just jump in here
real
quick? I just want to congratulate you on the first hour of your show here and really the work you've done all day paying a very fitting tribute to Aretha Franklin. And one of the things I think that this reminds us of is that there's only really been a handful of issues over the last couple of years that have kind of been able to break through the Trump news and own an hour of a show or an entire show, and it's nice to know that Aretha Franklin's extraordinary life remains one of those things.
Yeah. Michael, thank you for saying that, and Frank, thank you both for joining us.